Hey, folks, welcome to the show. Boy, this is the Spectrum, the Philadelphia Spectrum, home of the Broad Street Bullies. Let me tell you, some folks, they were tough. I'll tell you, teams used to come in here, they were shaken. They call it the Philly Flu. They were a tough group, but a good group, I'll tell you that. They used to have, oh boy, we had battles with the Boston Bruins, but I think the best one of all was with the Russians. My buddy Eddie Van Impe, boy, did he do a number on it. But let's Bob Cole tell you about it. Take it away, Bob.
The Flyers getting physical now. Oh, Kharlamov is really built it. There's that close man. Kharlamov, oh, again. Kharlamov is really built it by Van Impe. And he's not straight on the ice. Van Impe from the penalty box ran into Kharlamov. The Soviets are all standing up. They want a penalty, but I'll tell you, Dick, that was a solid check, and I didn't see too much wrong with it.
They are leaving the ice.
They're going to go.
The Soviets are leaving.
They're going home. They're going home. Yeah, they're going home.
Hey, the owner of the Flyers, Eddie Snyder, went to the Soviets and said, hey, if you don't come back, you're not getting any dough. They came back and the Flyers beat them 4-1. Okay, now for some beauty hits, just like my buddy Eddie Van Impe. Confessions for some hardcore rock and roll. Cannot offer you redemption. A temporary satisfaction for your soul. Too much time, you can't take anymore. You got a one-track mission on your mind. Crosby dropped the gloves with Zdlicky from Minnesota. Hey, Crosby can score gold medal goals, drop the gloves, pretty good too. You know, they always put the Philly fans down. They don't to me, and I'll tell you why. The Philly fans were always fair, tough. They never threw things at you like they did in Pittsburgh. But I'll tell you, when they'd get rocking, they'd have the Schultz's army going. You couldn't believe it. The sign guy got to the point after they'd score on us, I'd see what he's putting up. But you know the favorite of all that won them the Stanley Cup, no other than Bernie Parent. He was dynamite.
You are the anchor. I am the honey, you are the anchor. I am the ship, honey, you are the anchor. Down, bring me down, bring me down. You gotta hold on me, I'm about to drown.
The goalie's best friend, the post.
It's the shot, and it's in a dark and lonely place. I make you feel like you never heard before. They say the thrill is in the chase. You never get to it, I like this a lot more. Taking back the years of my life. A couple fat niggas spit out the bones. I'm just a wrong, not a street, it'll hang out. Ship, honey, you are the anchor. I am the ship, honey, you are the anchor. I am the ship, honey, you are the anchor. I am the ship, honey, you are the anchor. I am the ship, honey, you are the anchor. Yeah, I'm the ship, baby, you are the anchor. Down, bring me down, bring me down. You gotta hold on me, I'm about to drown. Bring me down, bring me down. You gotta hold on me, I'm about to drown.
Highlight of the night for you, other than the Delzato interview coming up here, is your buddy Matt Duchene.
Watch this here, his first goal. This guy is dynamite. All coaches and I talk to them, all hockey players love this guy. He's one of those guys, and I don't know if we can see it again, but he's one of those guys that it just, you love to, as a coach, you just love them, and he's got his first goal. Little devil, daddy, and now some great goals, starting with OB.
Do you want to show Powell and Giroux?
Yeah, we got a little thing if you want to show. I think you guys would love this one. And
this is Claude Giroux.
Yes. Now watch this, Giroux, from Hearst, Ontario. And watch this. This is by himself. Now he does it once more. Pretty good. Now watch this here. Now he can even work with somebody. Watch this here.
Daryl Powell, Saskatoon.
From Saskatoon boy. Like this here. Just a little fun that the guys have together. I don't know if he catches it here, though.
Trick rope.
Oh, he didn't catch it. We should have stopped it. Hey, that was pretty good. Now time for Blue's favorite funny things in hockey. Hey, Sydney, not bad. A smooth way to celebrate a goal. I gotta tell you, those gloves smell. Woo-hoo. Watch out for the boards. They'd call that a high stick. What are the odds? Hey, that's a killer. That's not funny. Now that's how to kill a penalty. Hey, let me tell you something, folks. I love those playoffs this year. That was rock'em sock'em hockey, I'll tell you. But how about Philly and New York Rangers? How about Philly makes it the last game on a shootout? And then they go down 3 with the Boston Bruins and they win. I'll tell you, boy, the playoffs are great. What a great playoffs this year. I loved it. Gotta tell you, in that first round, players are hungry and you gotta keep your head up. And every goal seems life and death.
Backhander scores! Recky goes in. Here's the spot back and then scores! And then backhand hit scores!
Everybody's got to pay the price or you're not going anywhere. Crosby, no look and a goal. Crosby with another beauty assist. Beauty overtime goals. Karkner sends it back to Pittsburgh.
Here comes the shot. Yeah.
shot from the blue line by Matt Parker, and the Ottawa Senators have won this game.
Staal with some great work, and Dupas wins the series for the Pens.
The shot is stopped.
Mechanic shocks the Caps in Game 1. Backroom saves the day for the Caps and ties the series at one game apiece. Satan scores in the second overtime on a power play for too many men on the ice. A sign of things to come for Boston.
Miro Satan, the overtime game.
Are the Bruins fans happy or what? My buddy Danny Cassello scores for Philly in Game 3. Now time for the best of the West. You know, last year was really anybody's cup to win. Any team that got a lucky bounce here or there could have won the whole thing.
Cloudy cuts to the net. Michael Samuelson moves in, takes the shot, scores!
Hey, lots of hits, great saves, and super goals.
Some open ice spins. What a save.
Look at this great save.
Miles, a one-timer. And a quick. And it's a great save by Quick. Out of the corner, keep the puck away. Daniel Sedin with a little back pass to his brother Henrik. Daniel heads for the net, takes the pass, scores! The puck in. He's got Frolov deep, gives him the puck. Modine scores!
Boyle, top corner.
Boyle now with urgency, he scores! Just this, Simmons after the puck. Spin, shoot, great save, Luongo!
Now the OT goals. Jamieson puts the Canucks up 1-0. Hey, what I've always said, shots from the point.
Henrik in front, Simmons scores! Kopitar, quick pass back to Johnson, fakes it. Doughty, Kopitar, great block by Kessler. Kopitar scores!
Kopitar scores on his own rebound to tie the series at one game apiece.
Los Angeles Kings win tonight 3-2. A power play goal ties the series 1-1.
Hawks tie up the game versus the Preds with a shorthanded goal with 13 seconds left, and an OT goal by Hossa gets the winner. Taniguchi scores a winner in Game 2 and a wild 6-5 win. What do I always say? Stick on the ice, kids. It is a tough one, folks. Dan Boyle's shot goes off the stick of my buddy Ryan O'Reilly for the winner in a 1-0 game. I'll tell you, that was a killer. But the Sharks bounced back.
What a fluke, and it's over!
Joe Pavelski scores a winner in the next game to tie the series at 2.
Pavelski with a snapshot! He scores!
Are they happy or what?
He ends it in overtime, and the series is tied!
Saturday night, Coach's Corner, Signature Night. Don, this is the beginning of, believe it or not, your 30th season.
It is.
On Hockey Night. Is that unbelievable? Neck of the noose all that
looking.
Time. And yes, look, montage of great looks. No school like an old school. Don Cherry in the Coach's Corner. Congratulations.
30 years.
On Hockey Night in Canada.
Okay, you just sit there tonight. I got a lot of things. You're in enough trouble as it is. First of all, what's with the jacket? I mean, one of my old ones. What is this? And you don't wear stripes with a plaid after stop with. What is that? What
it's a new look. Ron, my tailor, recommended it.
Imitation.
I'm quite proud of it.
What?
Yes, I'm quite proud of it. It's a nice look. Green shirt, I was a little worried
green
about.
Green shirt with stripes. And look at here, striped, never mind. And another
it's two
thing.
Weeks in a row, no.
Wait a minute.
What
yeah,
I'll
I
stop.
Know. Just
I'm
a minute.
Sorry. I'll phone you and find out what you're
yeah,
wearing.
All right. You'll never talk.
Now, watch this here. Here's Neil's hit on Hegman. Now, watch. We're going to show it again. Watch how the defenseman doesn't hold him up like they used to about 6 years ago. Now, watch. Watch, he goes in the corner. Normally, he would have held him up. A little pick would have saved Hegman right there. Now, we have another one. You all remember this one. We're going to show it. Kostopoulos on Van Ryan. Van Ryan's never been the same since this one. Now, show it over again where the defenseman could have picked a little and not let him go in there. See? Watch him go by. He normally would have had a stick out 6 years ago, and this Van Ryan would have never, ever got run like this. Sad to see stuff like that.
There's so many things at play here with a 20-year-old and a 16-year-old, the OHL versus the NHL. The Hall of Famers, by the way, didn't think the suspension, they didn't like it. They thought it was too stiff. But that's not the point, right? We are at a crossroads here. What are we going to do? And you have these
suggestions. I don't think there's solutions. Suggestions starting off. Let's see a few of them right here. And I was a defenseman. Be smart now, kids. Now, when you go in a race for the puck in the corner, I know your coach always says, get in there first and get it. Don't be a dummy, because what you do is that you give the other guy a chance to hit you. Never do that. Go in as a tie. That's what I always did, unless he went in first like a dummy. Don't give them. You create a good atmosphere for the other team. Don't be stupid. Let's see number two. All right. Let the goalie handle the puck. Watch Belfour right here. Now, the defenseman, watch. He'd get murdered here, too. Look, out he goes like that. I know you people put the rules, but that was a pretty good rule. And you get a good old fence walk. Look at that. There's a good old fence that way. And the defenseman does not get murdered. Watch him now. See that? Why should we penalize? Well, with no touch icing, that goes without saying. There's no sense in even talking about that. They won't do it. There's been so many people hurt. Know who's on the ice. You. Let's just see what Brett Hull said about this Hall of Famer. Go ahead, Brett.
Every time I went on the ice, I looked to see who was on the ice against me. Whether it was a guy like Stevie or Luke, where I knew we were going to play a little more of a finesse
physical.
Shift, or if it was, say, Bobby Bassan type player, that you better make sure, because if he's got a chance to hit you, he's going to lay a shoulder into you and make sure you know that he's on the ice and be aware.
It's the best angle we have.
There was Cam Jansen on Cabrera. That was an example of where you said Thomas probably should have had his head up.
Probably should have had his head up. He should have saw there's a pit bull. But here's the one here, the most important one. Never, never, go ahead, roll it with Tucker. Never, never turn your back when you go in near the boards on the puck. Bang. Poor Darcy, you know he's my favorite. He does the same thing against Ruto. He's got his back to it. And you know what happens when you get a guy like Ruto and that on, and he's injured for a while. All right, let's go.
Vancouver's got the best shot blocker in hockey.
Right? The best guy in the world, too, Ryan Johnson. Watch this here, BC boy, watch this here. Block shots. Now, folks, he's been out 5 games, and this is his first game back. Can you believe that? Thunder Bay, Ontario guy. This is his first game back from a concussion, and this is what he does. Unbelievable. That's the kind of guy you win with. Hey, I read in the paper, hey, quiet back there, eh?
Could be Mitzi. Is it Mitzi?
Could be Mitzi. Keep quiet, Mitzi, while I'm on here. I'm wearing your tie.
Don, the Montreal have their 100th anniversary. You went there in 1955 as a player. What I seem to remember for some reason is your mom and your aunt?
My Aunt Tilly were there. It was the only game I ever played. I took a regular shift. I think I was plus. And my claim to fame is I knocked down Belleville. And that was my claim to fame. And then I went to minors for the went to Siberia for the next 21 years.
But really, when you, I mean, to play in a Montreal form.
It was unbelievable. I walked in. Can I just tell, this is a great story, is that I start, Milt Schmidt started me. So I'm standing there and my head is, I can't believe it. So I didn't know, I come up to the American League, so I didn't know much too much in the National League. And Bernie Jeffrion won the scoring title. And he comes on, he's introduced in the game, and he gets booed off the ice. What the heck's going on? Then the Rocket come on, and he was second, standing ovation. And I found out that was the only time the Rocket could have won the scoring title, and Bernie beat him. And they never forgive Bernie for that. They just love the Rocket.
Because Clarence Campbell suspended the Rocket on March the 17th.
He punched out a guy named Hugh McLean, and he hit Lake over the head with a stick. Here's the thing. I'm in the pits all the time. When you're out... like I am, I know the Zamboni's driver's name. I'm in the pits. I know what's going on. Hordachuk, I think like Hordachuk thinks. The guys in the media don't think like hockey players. Mm-hmm. I still think I'm 32 years old as a hockey player. That happens. Peterson was a little guy. You don't hit little guys on your club, even if it was a clean hit. Hordachuk said the same thing. He's looking for a fight. Let's go. But the people in the commentaries don't understand.
And here's the great news for you, Don. There were a lot of Crosby signs. Sorry, Sid. Cherry, will you marry me?
Well, the guy's available for you, anyhow.
Good-looking guy she's dumping, I have to admit.
Bula Bula. Pat Burns, what a guy. Hey, you know what? He won the Coach of the Year. I thought I was a great guy winning it once. He wins it in three times with three different teams. Stanley Cup champion, what a guy. They named an arena after him. And as long as I'm on, you'll always be on Coach's Corner, Pat. Hang tough. Now watch this, kids. He's visualizing. He's visualizing. Watch this now. Now look at this. I've never seen anything like this. And watch at the very end, this is a long one, he's looking right at the spot where he shot the puck. See that? He's you know, I hear guys out there doing their sticks and everything. But isn't that something? Whatever he's doing right. Now look at you looking at that spot again. He got that spot down perfect. See that? He's getting ready to just snap that puck like that.
Bobby did this?
Bobby would be in the dressing room. He would not go out. Bobby would be in the afternoon at 2:30 in the afternoon, getting ready for a 7 o'clock game, just like he's getting ready, not quite as early. But Bobby would do the exact same thing. Now watch, it's that spot that he was looking. Watch that spot. Boom. And he had another great spot with it before. And see that spot? That's his spot visualizing. Kids, think about that. And now we have Bobby Orr with his flying through the air and a great statue. I'm a little worried about his nose, though. I don't know about that nose.
You had to bring that up, huh?
I know. It's Bobby Kidd. There's Bobby there.
40 years ago today, Don, he scored that goal.
He would have won 10 years in a row, the best defenseman, the greatest player who ever played the game. Never gets old, the guy. Isn't that something?
Hey, Loopy, right? What he says is, you got a winning formula, don't change a thing. Get that puck behind it, get those speed balls in there, be as tough as them, bang them, don't lay back, get that first goal. So important with this crowd, first goal. What do you think, Loopy? All right, Loopy says okay.
Now I want to do something, David Bowen. I love this guy, I've watched him since he's 13, and Brendan Shanahan, watch this here goal here. I guess we got to hurry. Anyhow, I want to tell a story.
Almost.
Anyhow, this guy was out for 3 months with a bad back, and he gets a goal like that. For all you kids, I get letters to you. I'll never come back. It happens. And this guy was out for 3 months with a back operation. If he did it, you can do it.
It was Brendan Shanahan's brother, Brian, was his coach, right?
I didn't have
10 seconds to say that, because Brendan's watching.
Well, I wanted to do it. You said hurry up.
Don Cherry in the Coach's Corner on Hockey Night in Canada.
Not get enough time here, you know that. All right, here it is. We're in the playoffs. We're going into overtime. It's game one in the playoffs. Let me tell you something, folks. The place is going nuts. So I got Jean Rattel out there. I got Ricky Middleton. And I got Donnie Marcotte. I look down at the bench, and he's putting in Bernie Parent. Wayne Stevenson has played the whole game. Going into overtime, he puts in Bernie Parent. I can't understand it. He's got to be cold. So I call the line over. He says, Jean, come here, come here. Donnie, come here. Now look, I want you to get the puck over. Jean, get the puck over to Ricky. Get Ricky, you get it. I don't care what you do. Flip it on Bernie. Flip it on him. He's got to be cold.
Rick Smith to Middleton on the move. Trying to beat Jimmy Watson. He goes wide. He shoots. Score! Goal! It's in! Rick Middleton has won the game as it's poked by Bernie Parent and just over the goal line. And Rick Middleton, his second rush down the right side, cut wide, drilled it. Parent had it, and then it just dropped over the line. Rick Middleton gives Boston the win.
And I did feel sorry for Bernie for just a second. Okay, now let's take a look at round two of the playoffs. Still a lot of hitting, folks.
Coming in with Legends. And on the other side, oh, and Jensen got that big shot. And then, great save by Halak. Big shot under Pollard in there. He sends it over. Out in front of the goal. Never shot to it.
How about Montreal? Tavlak against the Pen. Was he unbelievable or what? Philly coming back, not only down 3-0 in games, but down 3-0 in game 7. Hey, what a way to get loose, Boston. I felt so sorry for them. Hey, like you saw in Coach's Corner, Camilleri, was he in a zone against the Pens or what? For some OT goals. Hey, my good buddy Mark Savard, first game back from a concussion, and he gets the winner in game one. Way to go, Savvy! Gagner gets the winner in game four to keep Philly alive. Little did he know, he started Philly on the road back to four straight wins. Unbelievable. Hey, here we go, round two from out west.
For Samuelson, he scores.
You knew Chicago and Vancouver, it was going to be a great series. Hey, the Sharks and Wings weren't too bad either.
Erhoff takes the shot. Neiman the save. Nielsen. Shane O'Brien shoots.
I gotta tell you, Neiman has just stoned the Canucks.
Great save. Deets. Great save. Neiman. Here's Daniel. In front of great save by Neiman.
Two on one. Griffin to Gregory, scores! Passes off, Tate scores!
Demieux gets four goals and two assists in a 7-1 win in game five.
Couldn't shoot it. Patrick Sharp sent the puck across. Hold the mill.
Boy, was that great goaltending all around.
Keep the puck away right up the middle. Jose in front.
Here comes Eager. Adam Burns trying to break away. He belongs. Stopped by Luongo. To Sharp. He's in a long, deep straight. Passes off. Taves trying to stuff it in. Scores!
So jumps up. It's a two-on-one. Wellwood. Bieksa scores!
Here's Patrick Sharp to Brower. He scores! Across the ice. Here's Pat Kane.
Hey, I'm not sure what Kane calls this. Maybe the swim. Patrick Marleau gets the game winner with a beauty pass from Joel Thornton to put up the Sharks 3-0. Patrick will never get an easier overtime goal than that one. For all his friends and his family and everything in Calgary, number one star. Let's see it right now. We got a little Pac-Man?
Yes, we do.
Okay, look, can we see it? Now, this is his first game. Think about it, folks, how excited he'd be. Imagine, he's out there and he makes great shots. Too bad he didn't get a shutout, eh?
Yeah.
It would have been just one shot, eh?
I'm glad for Havlat.
Well, yeah, Havlat, I don't mind him. He's okay. But look at this. Like, he's ready. Isn't that good? I mean, I just love it when I see a kid go up there and do that. Knocking around. 400th, the next. Look at him. See, he's ready. Now, watch at the end.
Yeah.
Watch. Everybody's so happy. You think the happiest guy in the world. Where are they?
Keep going.
Whatever.
They're coming
Keep going.
In.
Well, what's the whole thing? I want to
get the celebration here.
Get the celebration, please.
And him coming out for the star, if we can, Brian, would be great. And I can tell you that Dean Brown caught up with him, so we'll have an interview in a little bit on our show here before we get to Washington and Edmonton. Here's that big scrum at the end. Where
here's what I like. I love this. Look at you. Think they're not happy for him? Happiest guy in the world. That's super. All his friends. Look at them.
I want to know who he pointed to, though. Just as you cut away, he pointed to one of the defensemen coming in.
Yeah.
Must have been a big shot block or something.
Now some more great saves, starting with Boston's Timmy Thomas. The Kings quick. Roberto. Heavy Bullen, boy, the Oilers sure missed him last year, I gotta tell you. Toskala. Tampa Bay's Ninnemäki with three beauties. Rask. Sometimes the goalies need a little help from their teammates. Watch this. And stops her on the line. Playoff hero Havlat. Anderson. Cam Ward. Conklin. Kia Beauty. Billy Boucher. The Isles Rollison. Hedberg. Fleury. Hey, nice save, Devin. And now the Flames tippers off. Time for some baseball. Watch these guys bat the puck right out of the midair and into the net. Stamkos even knocks it out of the air while he's laying on the ice. Watch the Oilers' Neeson show some sweet hands. Nice one by Kuhlman. Stick on the ice, kids. Nice deep. Nash with two. Hey, this one's for Ron McLean. One-handed tip, beauty. Caves with a sweet one. Nice. Bozak could be goal of the year.
Yes, it is. Bozak straight up the middle. He scores.
Camilleri with an end-to-ender.
Gets the center, gets to the line, gets down in front of the net, and scores.
Jason Spezza. Parisi breaks the stick, goes to the bench, gets a new one, bangs the stick on the ice, then gets a breakaway and wins the game in OT beauty. Again, the top corner. Hey, this is what I call crashing the net. King with a nice little move. The Sharks set a Gucci with a one-hander. Alvarezin top corner on Miller. Hey, Comrie with a little hesitation and then slides it along the ice. Beauty. Brad Boyce with a nice backhand. You don't see that much anymore. Top corner. The barrel between his legs, off a defenseman and in. My buddy Penner slides it home. Pembellini between his legs. The Trent gets nice goal. O'Sullivan with two. Peter Riegel with a wraparound.
Scores! Big hit, Willie Mitchell on Jonathan Toews.
All right, watch this one. Now, kids, keep your head up. Watch this suicide pass. This is a beauty coming across. Looked like he was changing or something there, eh? I love Toews. You know what I like to think about Jonathan. But here it is. Now, they have a little riot afterwards. Now, watch, they have a little riot afterwards. They go after him. I know you people say, why do they do that? It was a clean hit, and it was a clean hit, but you can't have your kid going like that. Get up, Jonathan. Don't you go down. Get up. You're a good Canadian boy. Get over there. More hits. I love it.
Now, you kids want to, well, let's see the goal first. Go ahead. Let's see Ovechkin's goal first. Now, watch this like a rocket. Boom. Boom. Now, you want to know, kids, how he gets it away? All right, we're coming up. Look at this. Watch the stick. Watch this here. Watch the curve on it. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Look, it's like a golf club or something. Hey, one of those, what do you call this approach in that?
Wedge?
Wedge, yeah, look at that. That's why it takes off like that. So you kids, if you want to have a shot like Ovechkin.
Would you recommend that, Don? Would you tell a child to use a three-quarter inch or
maybe
more
not
curve?
A child, but if you want to let a
okay, a midget want, hockey player.
Yeah, a midget hockey player. Hey, Bruce in the pudding. You want to let it go and start him young with something like that. Watch these blasters starting with two by OB.
Ovechkin shoots and scores. Look out for that drive, and it's in the net.
Jokinen. Ginla. Malkin. Gonchar. Koivu. Schneider. Weber. Spezza. Hardy. Drew Doughty. Dupree. Hey, watch the stick bend here. Delzato. Hey, my buddy Steven Stamkos with two beauties. I've been trying to get this in for 3 weeks. Now watch Korvalev. He does this a lot. No, okay, watch this now. This is beautiful. A little moonwalk, a little entertainment. Way to go, Corvy. All right, give a stick away too. Hey, folks, these are tough ones. The goalies don't have a chance. I call them bank shots. Pucks bounced at the last second on these ones. They look like an easy goal, but the goalies, they don't have a chance. We won the first game in overtime, I tell you, it was a dandy. But now we're in the second game, and we're in double overtime, if you can believe it. Terry O'Reilly, he jumps on by accident, and he's standing right here, and watch what happens.
Behind the net, Marcotte. In front, O'Reilly scores! Terry O'Reilly from Dan Marcotte. The Bruins win in the second sudden death overtime with 9:53 left as Marcotte fed. Terry O'Reilly right in front. He jammed it home. A mob scene around Jerry Cheevers, who has been absolutely magnificent.
Now we're in the semifinals. It's the Flyers and the Habs. You gotta say, now really, nobody expected these two teams to be in the semifinals. Remember, Philly got in a shootout in the last game.
And then Colburn was open on this side, but they go to Briere.
the net. Salary pass. Scores. And the shot scores. Greer scores a goal.
The thing he did, but here's Gagne getting around and running on goal.
Stop. Rebound. Here comes Gomez. Along. He stopped. Rebound.
And for Polichon. Shot.
If you ask me, I think the difference in the series was that Philly really started to crash the net and bug Havlak. And Leighton, I gotta say, he had an easier time of it.
And it's in the goal. Farted in front. It's fired in there behind everybody. It's out. And broken up and cleared. Down again to Giroux. The shot is stopped by Lockie inside the blue line.
But in the end, folks, the Flyers were just too much for the Canadiens. But hey, Montreal, they had a great playoffs.
I'm a believer in this. I think you should pick it up.
Yeah.
They've earned it. They deserve it.
Okay, now it's the Sharks and the Hawks. I gotta tell you, both teams come out hitting. I'll tell you, there was some nice goals in this series. And here's my buddy David Bolin. Oh, what a nice one. A beauty pass.
The shot short-handed. Mark Edward Plastic. Marlow scores! Up, hosts it just ahead of him, heads for the net. Richard is at the right point. Shot, shoots.
Niemena keeps up his great play.
Off the bench, he shoots. Niemi the same. Patrick Marleau passes off, tipped right on. Straight up the middle, Pavelski passes off. Mitchell's shot, but now he's in trouble. Here's another short-handed break. Marleau shoots, stopped by Niemi. Again, Taves lost the handle. And Brad Buffalo scores!
Buffalo scores the OT winner, and Hawks take a 3-0 lead in the series. What a pass by my buddy Bolin. The Hawks go on to sweep the series. Some great club saves, starting with three beauties from Marc-Andre Fleury. Joey McDonald. Volpoon. Brass. Havlak. Osgood. Word on Billy Guerin. Right on the line, Johnson, Mason, hey, here's Marty with two. Boston's Timmy Thomas, a Swedish monster, Guerin, Niedermaki, Price. Huron. Hey, here's three beauties by Kiprzov. Killer. Marty Turco. Hey, Delarice, I say something like that, but three in a row. UA. Elliott. And we
the end with five beauties by Roberto Luongo. Let's watch these guys pass it around, starting with my buddy Pinner to Gagne to Pouliot. Nielsen to Pouliot. Cogliano to Pinner. Beauty. Backstrom NOV with a little give and go.
Teaches it to the score.
Hey, watch the cast pass it around here. And in. Phillies Matt Carl to Richards. Hey, watch the Penguins use the boards here. Off the boards from behind the net to Crosby and in. Ryan O'Reilly to McLeod and it's in. Tucker behind the back to Sapko and in again. Stone behind the back to Lombardi and a nice backhand. I love those backhands. Topolsky, a long one to Miller. Kovacek, a long pass to Kozlov. Richards tomorrow and in. Merle's a nifty one to Ben. Two good guys, Getzlaf and Perry team up here. Mechanic to Camilleri with his stick on the ice and he snaps her home. Again, McGrattan's got a stick on the ice, and he puts her home, too. That was a beauty goal by Solstrom. Hey, Kelly sends Rudu in all alone. Taves to Sharp, back to Taves, and it's in. Hey, look at Nash, a no-looker to Vermette. I love it. Sutter sifts one over to Kostopoulos. One Sedin over to the other Sedin. Nice little drop pass to Lukowicz, and it's in two. Sedin to Sedin to Burles. You know, in sports, there's nothing like the Stanley Cup Finals. And to me, anyhow, it's like a heavyweight championship fight. I love it. And this year was no different. Let me tell you, Fire Chicago, they took no prisoners. Are you ready? Let's go. Game one in Chicago. Hey, you know, these two guys were gonna go at it, and they did.
Calder's on the ice again. He's played for the first 6.5 minutes as the Flyers get the puck to the net, and it's in. A bouncing puck gets behind Avi Niemi. Circling in the Flyers zone. Barrett lost his stick. Post a season. There's a shot by Bauer. He scores! Here comes Dustin Butler.
Niemi has stopped 17 shots in the first period, and they let him go.
Shoots. From the air by Niemi. That was blocked. Greer again scores! The Blackhawks have been dominant there. Here's a 2-on-1. It's Sharp. He shoots, he scores!
Yeah, it was seesaw back and forth.
Different looking line. Bauer, Sharp, and Kane. Aaron Asham. Here's Claire Betts with a shot. He scores! He answers the puck into the attacking zone. Here comes Thomas Kopetsky. Centering pass with Steve. Scores! Hossa. Centering pass comes back to Chalmers, and all he does is hold the puck in. Here's Hossa with Sharp in front. A centering pass.
I gotta tell you, it wasn't Leighton's night, but he'd be back.
Here comes Christopher Skeet, centering pass. Boucher makes a great save. Here's Pierre with a shot. He's got Colbert clear, and he shoots. There's Hartnell with him. Hartnell takes the pass, hits the trailer. Asher can't shoot. Pierre to Asher, one-timer scores! With the skates, and he fell down. The Bolin kept the puck in. For Skeet, got front to Pesky, scores!
Jayhawks with a crazy one, 6-5. And now game two in Chicago. Oh,
check by Richards, who stole the puck, takes the shot, the empty to save. He has joined the rush, and he shoots right with the save. Here's Brent Seabrook. Duncan Keith into Sharp. He shoots right with the save. Rebound.
I love seeing those tough guys score.
Campbell, Kopetsky to the long side. Jeff Carter knocked down, and look at this, nose to nose. Thomas Kopetsky and Dan Carcillo. Slap pass, side of the net. Gagne stopped by the Indians. A steal. Bauer stop. Rebound. Hossa, Greg shoots, and that's blocked in front of the net. Bowen, there's a shot, but lands by Trump. Corner comes the captain, and he shoots and fights that off. Kennelly's just about over. There's the shot by Gagne, scores!
Hey, Layton keeps Philly in there, and they score to make it 2-1.
Here's a chance for Ashton, and what a save by Miami. Carcillo again steps the shot. Here's Timo Tiivanen to the net. The save is made, and the puck is loose. To Mike Richards behind the defense. He's stopped by
the Emmy. Tiivanen makes 32 saves, and the Hawks go up 2-0. Hey, Game 3 was in Philly, and you know the joint was going to be rocking.
Thomas Kopetsky bounces one in on Michael. Hold of the puck to Patrick Sharp. He's got Hossa with him. He gave him the puck. His shot, a nice save by Lynn. Taken by Giroux. Colbert shot. Oh, what a save by the Emmy. They score. Denny Briere. Oh, straight up the middle. Darryl Powell turns and fires. Oh. Giroux plays it back. Chris Porter. Wrist shot to Blackburn. Oh, off, the light is on, but I don't think that puck got across the goal line.
Hey, was it a goal?
It was a goal.
He won the draw. Sofal shoots, he scores! Another shot knocked down in front of the goal. Tage gets it, feeds it ahead. Here's Patrick Kane, scores! The board, the puck is stolen. There's a hot shot, and the Emmy made the save on the neutral zone. There's a steal by guess who? Billy Lane. Thomas, it doesn't have a stick. Briere, stop! Sorry, pass, rebound, score!
We go to overtime.
There's a chance in the front of the net.
Say, was it a goal?
Here's Briere, Matt Carl tips it on, they score!
It was, and Philly wins, and Layton makes 33 saves. Way to go, Layton. Hey, the Philly fans are ready.
Don't make no plans for next Wednesday night, because we'll be right back here in Philadelphia to lift the Stanley Cup.
Play continues as Jeff Carter, he shoots, and Miami makes the save. Billy Leno, Briere, hit the post. Mike Richards and Billy Leno. And Ogagne is powered by a steal and a goal. Mike Richards.
Hey, this one was all Philly early.
Held it in along the boards. Here's Claude Giroux. Coming off the bench is James Van Riemsdyk with a spinorama in front of the net. Giroux turns and fires. They score! Oh, that cycling came without shots. Hartnell didn't get the puck out. Sharp with a shot. Scores!
deflected as Patrick Sharp.
In the last minute of the first period, Cardinal holds up, waiting for Tiedemann off the bench, side of the net, he scores! Patrick Kane, Tate goes to the front of the net this time. Duncan Keith takes the shot, tipped in by Boland.
Yeah, the Hawks are keeping it close, though.
Outside, to the front of the net, a bouncy puck, they score! Looked like it went off Jonathan Tate. Steve battling in front. There's a tip. Seabrook right on. Martin Sokol, one-timer, off and sticks. Taves can't beat late. Taves again, wrap around. Duncan Keith shoots, just missed it in. Here's Fred Seabrook back in front of the box and hit the puck. And he goes wide of the net. Duncan Keith can't hold the puck in. Jeff Carter steals it. Open net. Game over.
And now back to Chicago. Dustin Byfuglien was a one-man wrecking crew. Two goals, two assists, and lots of bodies flying, and they let him go. Are they nuts?
He's looking, shoot, he scores! Get to the point. There's Brent Sobel. Turns, puts the puck to the net. Ball and scores! Up the middle comes Blair Betts. There's the shot. Rebound. Betts couldn't find it. Pass off. Then he got over his stick. In comes Ladd. Sharp shoots. Big rebound. Sharp again. Stopped by Lynn. Two on two. Trying to make a three on two is Buffalo. For Steve. It's off. And he shoots. He scores. Back to the blue line. Cover just off the bench to Tiedemann. And he shoots. Rebound. The Emmy stopped that too. Patrick Sharp. He's got Kane, but he shoots. Another shot. Kane scores. Now he passes to Leno. He's caught. Hunter couldn't get it. Tiedemann scores. Calgary comes up with a puck and drives. Richards. Oh, what a save by Miami. And Taves in on Carter. He shoots. Kane. Quick pass to Keith. Side of the net. Taves to Buffalo. Gives Leno a chance to move out. He's got Simone Gagné with him, and Keith doesn't have a stick. Billy Leno to the net, passes off. Gagné scores. What a goal created by
Kane. Reminds me of another Blackhawk, Dennis Savard, with these moves.
Here's Buffalo, shoots for the open net.
And now game six. Better keep your head up in Philly.
Slides into the middle, passes off. Patrick Kane, Jonathan Taves, Byfuglien scores! Now back to Ponger. Here's Danny Breer, walks in, shoots, the empty to save, Ponger scores! Kane takes over. Byfuglien's with him, they crisscross. Kane shoots, late in the screen. Cross for Sokol, there's a screen, slap pass, side of the net.
Both goalies are keeping their teams in there.
The stage, and Keith wires it. Leno, and a pitching cover, and there's a chance for Richards. And he flips the puck in the air to center. Leno knocked it down, onside, Billy Leno, Breer scores! Danny Breer! Keith will lead the way into the attacking zone. Passes into the middle. Boland passes off. Sharp scores! Matt Carl pinches down. Held the puck in. Thrown to the net. Here's Giroux. Stopped by Niemi. Here's Brayden Coburn. He's joined the rush. Jeff Carter shoots. Niemi stopped it. There's a rebound there, though he couldn't stop the play. Here's a steal. Simone Gagné. Give it all. Stopped by Niemi. Give away Richards. Just about got away with that. Now he throws the puck to the front of the net. Bouncing puck, Giroux! Matt Carl under pressure in his own zone. He lost the puck. Patrick Kane won't give it up. Nicklas Hjalmarsson shoots, deflected, they score! And Jonathan Taves to Marian Hossa. Batten's with it. So here comes Taves. Stopped by Leighton. Back to the front of the net.
Jefferson got a high stick shoot.
And no one has the puck. Little backhand pass to Duncan Keith. Fires a shot off the post.
Out here with Briere and Hartnell. Gets through the neutral zone into the attacking zone. Hartnell heads for the net. Briere's already there. Let's see what they score!
Scotty Hartnell ties up the game and he sends it into overtime.
Into the line, turns, won't shoot. Kane, watched by Kimo Tiivanen, to the net. And he stopped it. Where's the puck?
Hey, Kane knew it was in.
Patrick Kane has scored the goal. The Chicago Blackhawks' long drought is over.
He still can't find the puck.
And there it is.
There's the puck.
Well, congratulations to the Hawks. I gotta tell you, folks, that's moments to live forever. Well, folks, that's the end of the show. You know, it's kind of sad. This grand old building's going to be torn down in a couple of months. Probably the last thing ever done in here. And, you know, there's been so many things in this. Stanley Cup wins, fights, some great fights. The Russians, Freddie Shiro, the Broad Street Bullies. There's been so much. But the one thing I remember most when I come into this building, and I remember before the games, Kate Smith saying, God bless America with this grand old flag. Well, folks, it's time to end it with some of the best plays of the year. Folks, you won't believe this story, but it's a true story. It's unbelievable. What happened was the Philadelphia Flyers, the Boston Bruins had an exhibition game. It was fight after fight after fight. You couldn't believe it. I was down to six guys on the bench. All of a sudden, Cashman and them in the ice had a stick fight, a beauty stick fight, and they were kicked out of the game. And I look down and I hear somebody holler, "Hey, fight in the halls, fight in the halls." I look over, there's the Flyers going up the halls. So naturally, my guys are going up the halls too, and this is the halls they went up. So I followed them up in here, and what the heck is going on? I come up here, that's our dressing room, that's their dressing room down there, and down here, you couldn't believe it, fight after fight, It was a mass of humanity. Cops were in, kicking one another, pulling guys. I'm in trying to get players. It was unbelievable what happened. Well, Cashman got 10 games and Holmgren got 10 games. And evidently Cashman had said something to Holmgren as he went to the bench into his room. And he come running down and in here hacking and banging and everything. It was unbelievable. So the league, believe it or not, this is a true story. The league said no more of that stuff. And they put the Holmgren Cashman gate here, and this is the original gate. I tell you, boys, it was tough in those days.
And now we have New Jersey, Pierre LeBron and St. Louis, Cam Jansen. They're ready to go. Watch the players in the background. They're ready to go. They knew it was going to happen. You're going to see one of the longest fights. We had to cut it down, folks. It was over 2 minutes. I have never seen a longer one than that. I remember Bobby Probert and Marty McSorley went in Detroit, but boy, this is the longest of all. We had to cut it down. You know what's hurt the most me in these fights, me not bangs to my head a lot, was my neck. Watch how they pull the sweaters on the back of their necks there. Boy, I don't know how they don't break their hands here. This is one of the toughest, and they don't go down. I mean, these are haymakers, and they're going. This is one of the longest, I'll tell you. They took no prisoners in this one. I can't believe they don't break their hands on those helmets, and they just keep going. Now watch them trying to get their elbow pads off. They watch to keep throwing like that. I always used to have mine loose all the time. What, see him go with his right hand? He's trying to get them. And I used to have mine so loose, it would, one punch and it was gone. I'll tell you, watch the uppercuts. LeBron's giving a lot of uppercuts like that. And there's a sequence here, if you look, LeBron's laughing. See him try to get it ready like that? And watch as you know a punch coming. Watch, turn your head a little bit like that. Now, I'm not telling you to fight like that, but that's, if you're going to go, you have to keep your head side like that. Don't just go straight on. But these guys are going. They went over 2 minutes. The crowd is going nuts. Now, watch at the end when they finally go. They pat each other on the, even though one of them gets a shot at the end, they pat one another and they say, two warriors going at it. That LeBron uses that left like that. That doesn't look hard, but it's hard on your chin when he's doing that all the time. And you see Jansen, they said, do you want us to break it up? And he says, no way, we're going to keep going. You cannot believe how tired these guys are. I mean, they're just shaking after a while. This is one of the best fights to watch. He even gets a shot in. Two warriors. That's the way to do it. And look at the players. Look at the crowd. And they say they don't like fights. Two of the best, LeBron and Jansen. And they look at one another. They say, way to go.
Looking good, Don. All yours.
All right. Perfect.
Wow.
Perfect. Don't get me to do it again. That's all.
Alrighty. So you want me to show Don? Here's what we envisage.
Yes.
Best picture I ever saw of you is when you're, you know, pointing. So you come, you can look down. It's good, kind of good if you're looking down like this, and you're talking right to Bing, you know.
Yeah. All right. That's good.
That's your best picture, and you'll be looking down at the bench and saying, "Oh my God, how come there's only 11 guys here?"
Yeah.
Stanley, Don, Terry. Oh, jeez.
Yeah.
Not again.
Shut up.
Yeah, okay. Raise your thumb because I'm zooming in. There you go. That's
okay.
Here we go. If you want to get really authoritative, it's a great shot.
Let's see.
Yeah, you're scaring me. Good.
Yeah.
Jeez, I think that was your best one.
I'll never top that. Yeah.
Here we go.
Okay. Hold on, everybody. Everybody stop moving around and get out of the way. No, I want to say he's standing right here. No, all I said he's standing in front of the net. That's it. You want me to do another one or are they good enough?
No, I loved it. How about you?
I'll do one more just for...
All right.
How you like that?
Woo-hoo.
Good.
Do you want to show Pau and Giroux?
Yeah, we got a little thing if you want to show. I think you guys would love this one. And
this is Claude Giroux.
Yes. Now watch this, Giroux, from Hearst, Ontario. And watch this. This is by himself. Now he does it once more. Pretty good. Now watch this here. Now he can even work with somebody. Watch this here.
Daryl Powell,
from Saskatoon boy. Like this here. Just a little fun that the guys have together. I don't know if he catches it here though.
Trick rope.
Oh, I didn't catch it. We should have stopped it here. Hey, that was pretty good. Now time for Blue's favorite funny things in hockey.
Hey, Cindy, not bad. Hey, smooth way to celebrate a goal. I gotta tell you, those gloves smell. Watch out for the boards. I'd say they'd call that a high stick. That's a killer. That's not funny. Now that's how to kill a penalty. I've been trying to get this in for 3 weeks. Now watch Korvalev. He does this a lot. No. Okay, watch this now. This is beautiful. A little moonwalk. A little entertainment, way to go, Corby. All right, give a stick away, too. Hey, folks, these are tough ones. The goalies don't have a chance. I call them bank shots. Pucks bounced at the last second on these ones. They look like an easy goal, but the goalies, they don't have a chance. With three beauties from Marc-Andre Fleury. Joey McDonald. Volpoon. Brass. Pavlak. Osgood. Word on Billy Guerin. Right on the line. Johnson. Mason. Hey, here's Marty with two. Boston's Timmy Thomas. A Swedish monster. Guerin. Niedermacki. Price. Biron. Here's three beauties by Kiprzov.
Marty Turco. Hey, Delarice, I say something like that, but three in a row. UA. Ottawa's Elliott. And we end with Five Beauties by Roberto Longo. You know, they always put the Philly fans down. They don't to me, and I'll tell you why. The Philly fans were always fair, tough. They never threw things at you like they did in Pittsburgh. But I'll tell you, when they'd get rocking, they'd have the Schultz's army going. You couldn't believe it. The sign guy got to the point after they'd score on us, I'd see what he's putting up. But you know the favorite of all that won them the Stanley Cup, no other than Bernie Parent. He was dynamite. The post. And his family and everything in Calgary. Number one star. Let's see it right now. We got a little pack by him?
Yes, we do.
Okay, look, can we see it? Now, this is his first game. Think about it, folks, how excited he'd be. Imagine he's out there and he makes great shots. Too bad he didn't get a shutout, eh?
Yeah.
It would have been just one shot, eh?
I'm glad for Havlat.
Well, yeah, Havlat, I don't mind him. He's okay. But look at this. Like, he's ready. Isn't that good? I mean, I just love it when I see a kid go up there and do that, knocking around. 400, the next, look at him, see, he's ready. Now watch at the end, yeah. watch, everybody's so happy. You think the happiest guy in the world. Where are they?
Keep going.
What happened?
They're coming
in.
Well, what's the whole thing? I want to
get the celebration here.
Get the celebration, please.
And him coming out for the star if we can, Brian, would be great. And I can tell you that Dean Brown caught up with him, so we'll have an interview in a little bit on our show here before we get to Washington and Edmonton. Here's that big scrum at the end.
Here's what I like. I love this. Look at you. Think they're not happy for him? Happiest guy in the world. That's super. All his friends. Look at them.
I want to know who he pointed to, though. Just as you cut away, he pointed to one of the defensemen coming in.
Yeah.
Must have been a big shot block or something.
Now some more great saves, starting with Boston's Timmy Thomas. The Kings quick. Roberto. Heavy villain, boy. The Oilers sure missed him last year, I gotta tell you. Koskela. Tampa Bay's Ninimaki with three beauties. Rask. Sometimes the goalies need a little help from their teammates. Watch this. And stops are on the line. Playoff hero Havlak. Anderson. Cam Ward. Conklin. Hey, a beauty. Philly Boucher. The Isles Rollison. Hedberg. Flurry. Hey, nice save, Devin. And now the Flames kippers off.
Saturday night, Coach's Corner, Signature Night. Don, this is the beginning of, believe it or not, your 30th season.
It is.
On Hockey Night. Is that unbelievable? Neck of the
it's
noose
still
all that
looking.
Time. And yes, look, montage of great looks. No school like an old school. Don Cherry in the Coach's Corner. Congratulations.
30 years.
On Hockey Night in Canada.
Okay, you just sit there tonight. I got a lot of things. You're in enough trouble as it is. First of all, what's with the jacket? I mean, one of my old ones. What is this? And you don't wear stripes with a plaid after stop with. What is that?
It's a new look run by Taylor. Recommended
imitation.
I'm quite proud of it.
What?
Yes, I'm quite proud of it. It's a nice look. Green shirt, I was a little worried
green
about.
Green shirt with stripes. And look at here, striped, never mind. And another
it's two
thing.
Weeks in a row, no.
Wait a minute.
Yeah,
I'll
stop.
Just
I'm
a minute.
Sorry. I'll phone you and find out what you're
yeah,
wearing.
All right. You'll never talk. And now watch this here. Here's Neil's hit on Hegman. Now watch. We're going to show it again. Watch how the defenseman doesn't hold him up like they used to about 6 years ago. Now watch.
Watch, he goes in the corner. Normally, he would have held him up. A little pick would have saved Hegman right there. Now, we have another one. You all remember this one. We're going to show it. Kostopoulos on Van Ryan. Van Ryan's never been the same since this one. Now, show it over again where the defenseman could have picked a little and not let him go in there. See? Watch him go by. He normally would have had a stick out 6 years ago, and this Van Ryan would have never, ever got run like this. Sad to see stuff like that.
There's so many things at play here with a 20-year-old and a 16-year-old, the OHL versus the NHL. The Hall of Famers, by the way, didn't think the suspension, they didn't like it. They thought it was too stiff, but that's not the point, right? We are at a crossroads here. What are we going to do? And you have these
suggestions. I don't think they're solutions. Suggestions starting off. Let's see a few of them right here. And I was a defenseman. Be smart now, kids. Now, when you go in a race for the puck in the corner, I know your coach always says, get in there first and get it. Don't be a dummy, because what you do is that you give the other guy a chance to hit you. Never do that. Go in as a tie. That's what I always did, unless he went in first, like a dummy. Don't give them, you create a good atmosphere for the other team. Don't get be stupid. Let's see number two. All right, let the goalie handle a puck. Watch Belfour right here. He now the defenseman, watch, he'd get murdered here too. Look, out he goes like that. I know you people put the rules, but that was pretty good rule, and you get a good offense walk. Look at that. There's a good offense that way, and the defenseman does not get murdered. Watch him now. See that? Why should we penalize while with no touch icing? That goes without saying. There's no sense in even talking about that. They won't do it. There's been so many people hurt. Know who's on the ice. You. Let's just see what Brett Hull said about this Hall of Famer. Go ahead, Brett.
Every time I went on the ice, I looked to see who was on the ice against me. Whether it was a guy like Stevie or Luke, where I knew we were going to play a little more of a finesse physical shift, or if it was, say, Bobby Bassan type player, that you better make sure, because if he's got a chance to hit you, he's going to lay a shoulder into you and make sure you know that he's on the ice and be aware.
It's the best angle we have.
There was Cam Jansen on Caberly. That was an example of where you said Thomas probably should have had his head up.
Probably should have had his head up. He should have saw there's a pit bull. But here's the one here, the most important one. Never, never, go ahead, roll it with Tucker. Never, never turn your back when you go near the boards on the puck. Bang. Poor Darcy, you know he's my favorite. He does the same thing against Ruto. He's got his back to it. And you know what happens when you get a guy like Ruto and that on, and he's injured for a while. All right, let's go.
Vancouver's got the best shot blocker in hockey.
Right, the best guy in the world, too, Ryan Johnson. Watch this here, BC boy, watch this here. Block shots. Now, folks, he's been out 5 games, and this is his first game back. Can you believe that? Thunder Bay, Ontario guy. This is his first game back from a concussion, and this is what he does. Unbelievable. That's the kind of guy you win with. Hey, I read in the paper. Hey, quiet back there, eh?
Could be Mitzi.
Could be Mitzi. Keep quiet, Mitzi, while I'm on here. I'm wearing your tie.
Don, the Montreal have their 100th anniversary. You went there in 1955 as a player. What I seem to remember for some reason is your mom and your aunt?
My Aunt Tilly were there. It was the only game I ever played. I took a regular shift. I think I was plus. And my claim to fame is I knocked down Belleville. And that was my claim to fame. And then I went to minors went to Siberia for the next 21 years.
But really, to play in a Montreal form.
It was unbelievable. I walked in. Can I just tell this is a great story. Is that I start, Milt Schmidt started me. So I'm standing there and my head is, I can't believe it. So I didn't know, I come up to the American League. So I didn't know much to the National League. And Bernie Jeffrion won the scoring title. And he comes on, he's introduced in the game, and he gets booed off the ice. What the heck's going on? Then the Rocket come on, and he was second, standing ovation. And I found out that was the only time the Rocket could have won the scoring title, and Bernie beat him. And they never forgive Bernie for that. They just love the Rocket.
Because Clarence Campbell suspended the Rocket on March the 17th.
Yeah, well, he punched out a guy named Hugh McLean, and he hit Lake over the head with a stick. Here's the thing. I'm in the pits all the time. When you're out, like I am, I know the Zamboni's driver's name. I'm in the pits. I know what's going on. Hordachuk, I think like Hordachuk thinks. The guys in the media
don't think like hockey players. Mm-hmm. I still think I'm 32 years old as a hockey player. That happens. Peterson was a little guy. You don't hit little guys on your club, even if it was a clean hit. Hornacek said the same thing. He's looking for a fight. Let's go. But the people in right. the commentaries don't understand.
And here's the great news for you, Don. There were a lot of Crosby signs. Sorry, Sid. Cherry, will you marry me?
Well, the guy's available for you, anyhow.
Good-looking guy she's dumping, I have to admit.
Bula Bula. Ah, Pat Burns, what a guy. Hey, you know what? He won the Coach of the Year. I thought I was a great guy winning it once. He wins it in three times with three different teams. Stanley Cup champion, what a guy. They named an arena after him. And as long as I'm on, you'll always be on Coach's Corner, Pat. Hang tough.
Now watch this, kids. He's visualizing. He's visualizing. Watch this now. Now look at this. I've never seen anything like this. And watch at the very end, this is a long one, he's looking right at the spot where he shot the puck. See that? He's I hear guys out there doing their sticks and everything. But isn't that something? Whatever he's doing right. Now look at you looking at that spot again. He got that spot down perfect. See that? He's getting ready to just snap that puck like that.
Bobby did this?
Bobby would be in the dressing room. He would not go out. Bobby would be in the afternoon at 2:30 in the afternoon, getting ready for a 7 o'clock game, just like he's getting ready, not quite as early. But Bobby would do the exact same thing. Now watch, it's that spot that he was looking. Watch that spot, boom. And he had another great spot with it before. And see that spot? That's his spot visualizing. Kids, think about that. And now we have Bobby Orr with his flying through the air and a great statue. I'm a little worried about his nose, though. I don't know about that nose.
You had to bring that up, huh?
I know, it's Bobby Kidd. And there's Bobby there.
40 years ago today, Don, he scored that goal.
He would have won 10 years in a row, the best defenseman, the greatest player who ever played the game. Never gets old, the guy. Isn't that something?
Hey, Loopy, right? What he says is, you got a winning formula, don't change a thing. Get that puck behind it, get those speed balls in there, be as tough as them, bang them, don't lay back, get that first goal. So important with this crowd, first goal. What do you think, Loopy? All right, Loopy says okay. Now I want to do something, David Bowen. I love this guy, I've watched him since he's 13, and Brendan Shanahan, watch this here goal here. I guess we got to hurry. Anyhow, I want to tell a story.
Almost.
Anyhow, this guy was out for 3 months with a bad back, and he gets a goal like that. For all you kids, I get letters to you. I'll never come back. It happens. And this guy was out for 3 months with a back operation. If he did it, you can do it.
It was Brendan Shanahan's brother, Brian, was his coach, right?
I didn't have
10
time.
Seconds to say that, because Brendan's watching.
Well, I wanted to do it. You said hurry up.
Don Cherry in the Coach's Corner on Hockey Night in Canada.
Not get enough time here, you know that.
Well, folks, that's the end of the show. You know, it's kind of sad. This grand old building's going to be torn down in a couple of months. Probably the last thing ever done in here. And, you know, there's been so many things in this. Stanley Cup wins, fights, some great fights, the Russians, Freddie Shirl, the Broad Street Bullies. There's been so much. But the one thing I remember most when I come into this building, and I remember before the games, Kate Smith saying, God bless America, with this grand old flag.
Well, folks, it's time to end it with some of the best plays of the year.
Good job.
Folks, you won't believe this story, but it's a true story. It's unbelievable. What happened was the Philadelphia Flyers and the Boston Bruins had an exhibition game. It was fight after fight after fight. You couldn't believe it. I was down to six guys on the bench. All of a sudden, Cashman and them in the ice had a stick fight, a beauty stick fight, and they were kicked out of the game. And I look down and I hear somebody holler, "Hey, fight in the halls, fight in the halls." I look over, there's the Flyers going up the halls. So naturally, my guys are going up the halls too. And this is the halls they went up. So I followed them up in here. And I, what the heck is going on? I come up here, that's our dressing room. That's their dressing room down there. And down here, you couldn't believe it, fight after fight. It was a mass of humanity. Cops were in, kicking one another, pulling guys. I'm in trying to get players. It was unbelievable what happened. Well, Cashman got 10 games and Holmgren got 10 games. And evidently Cashman had said something to Holmgren as he went to the bench into his room. And he come running down and in here hacking and banging and everything. It was unbelievable. So the league, believe it or not, this is a true story. The league said no more of that stuff. And they put the Holmgren Cashman gate here, and this is the original gate. I tell you, boys, it was tough in those days.
And now we have New Jersey, Pierre LeBrun and St. Louis, Cam Jansen. They're ready to go. Watch the players in the background. They're ready to go. They knew what was going to happen. You're going to see one of the longest fights. We had to cut it down, folks. It was over 2 minutes. I have never seen a longer one than that. I remember Bobby Probert and Marty McSorley went in Detroit, but boy, this is the longest of all. We had to cut it down. You know what's hurt the most me in these fights, me not bangs to my head a lot, was my neck. Watch how they pull the sweaters on the back of their necks there. Boy, I don't know how they don't break their hands here. This is one of the toughest. And they don't go down. I mean, these are haymakers, and they're going. This is one of the longest, I'll tell you. They took no prisoners in this one. I can't believe they don't break their hands on those helmets, and they just keep going. Now watch them trying to get their elbow pads off. They watch, they keep throwing like that. I always used to have mine loose all the time. What, see him go with his right hand? He's trying to get them. And I used to have mine so loose, it would, one punch and it was gone. I'll tell you, watch the uppercuts. LeBron's giving a lot of uppercuts like that. And there's a sequence here, if you duck, LeBron's laughing. See him trying to get it ready like that? And watch as you know a punch coming. Watch, turn your head a little bit like that. Now, I'm not telling you to fight like that, but that's, if you're going to go, you have to keep your head side like that. Don't just go straight on. But these guys are going. They went over 2 minutes. The crowd is going nuts. Now, watch at the end when they finally go. They pat each other on the, even though one of them gets a shot at the end, they pat one another, and they say, two warriors going at it. That LeBron uses that left like that. That doesn't look hard, but it's hard on your chin when he's doing that all the time. And you see Jansen, they said, do you want us to break it up? And he says, no way, we're going to keep going. You cannot believe how tired these guys are. I mean, they're just shaking after a while. This is one of the best fights to watch. He even gets a shot in. Two warriors. That's the way to do it. And look at the players. Look at the crowd. And they say they don't like fights. Two of the best, LeBron and Jansen. And they look at one another. They say, way to go.
Highlight of the night for you, other than the Delzato interview coming up here, is your buddy Matt Duchene.
Watch this here. His first goal. This guy is dynamite. All coaches, and I talk to them, all hockey players love this guy. He's one of those guys, and I don't know if we can see it again, but he's one of those guys that it just, you love to, as a coach, you just love them, and he's got his first goal. Little devil down, and now some great goals, starting with OV.
Tell me, what's up around?
Time for some baseball. Watch these guys bat the puck right out of the midair and into the net. Stamkos even knocks it out of the air while he's laying on the ice. Watch the Oilers, Neeson, show some sweet hands. Nice one by Kuhlman. Stick on the ice, kids. Nice deep. Nash with two. Okay, this one's for Ron McLean. One-handed tip, beauty. James with a sweet one. Nice. Bozak could be goal of the year.
Yes, it is. Bozak straight up the middle.
Camilleri with an end-to-ender.
Gets the center, gets to the line, gets down in front of the net, and scores!
Jason Spezza.
It's a steaming lightning, he scores!
Parisi breaks the stick, goes to the bench, gets a new one, bangs the stick on the ice, then gets a breakaway and wins the game in OT beauty. Again, the top corner. Hey, this is what I call crashing the net. Kane with a nice little move. The Sharks, Setoguchi with a one-hander. Alvarezson, top corner on Miller. Hey, Comrie with a little hesitation and then slides it along the ice. Beauty. Brad Boyce with a nice backhand. You don't see that much anymore. Top corner. The barrel between his legs, off a defenseman, and in. My buddy Penner slides it home. Ambolini between his legs. Latrangas, nice goal. O'Sullivan with two. Peter Riga with a wraparound. Let's watch these guys pass it around, starting with my buddy Pinner to Gagne to Pouliot. Nielsen to Pouliot. Cogliano to Pinner. Beauty. Backstrom NOV with a little give and go.
Teaches it by, he scores.
Hey, watch the cast pass it around here. And in. Phillies Matt Carl to Richards. Hey, watch the Penguins use the boards here. Off the boards from behind the net to Crosby and in. Ryan O'Reilly to McLeod and it's in. Tucker behind the back to Stamkos and in again. Doan behind the back to Lombardi and a nice backhand. I love those backhands. Rafalski, a long one to Miller. Kovacek, a long pass to Kozlov. Richards tomorrow and in. Merle's a nifty one to Ben. Two good guys, Getzlaf and Perry, team up here. Mechanic to Camilleri with his stick on the ice, and he snaps her home. Again, McGrattan's got his stick on the ice, and he puts her home, too. That was a beauty goal by Sjolstrom. And Kelly sends Rudu in all alone. Taves to Sharp, back to Taves, and it's in. Okay, look at Nash, a no-looker to Vermint. I love it. Sutter sips one over to Kostopoulos. One Sedin over to the other Sedin. Nice little drop pass to Lukowicz, and it's in two. Sedin to Sedin to Burles.
Now, you kids want to, well, let's see the goal first. Go ahead. Let's see Ovechkin's goal first. Now, watch this like a rocket. Boom. Boom. Now, you want to know, kids, how he gets it away? All right, we're coming up. Look at this. Watch the stick. Watch this here. Watch the curve on it. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Look, it's like a golf club or something. Hey, one of those, what do you call this approach in that?
Wedge.
Wedge, yeah, look at that. That's why it takes off like that. So you kids, if you want to have a shot like Ovechkin.
Would you recommend that, Don? Would you tell a child to use a three-quarter inch or
well, maybe
more
not a
curve?
Child, but if you want to let a...
a midget you know, hockey player.
Yeah, a midget hockey player. Hey, Bruce in the pudding. You want to let it go and start him young or something like that. Watch these blasters starting with two by OB.
Ovechkin shoots and scores. Look out for that drive and it's in the net.
Jokinen. Ginla. Malkin. Gonchar. Koivu. Schneider. Weber. Spezza. Hardy. Drew Doughty. Dupree. Hey, watch the stick bend here. Dalzotto. Hey, my buddy Steven Stamkos with two beauties. Hey, folks, welcome to the show. Boy, this is the Spectrum, the Philadelphia Spectrum, home of the Broad Street Bullies. Let me tell you, some folks, they were tough. I'll tell you, teams used to come in here, they were shaken. They call it the Philly flu. They were a tough group, but a good group, I'll tell you that. They used to have, oh boy, we had battles with the Boston Bruins, but I think the best one of all was with the Russians. My buddy Eddie Van Imp. Boy, did he do a number on it. But let's Bob Cole tell you about it. Take it away, Bob.
The fire's getting physical now. Oh, Kharlamov has really built it. Where's that post man? Kharlamov, oh, again. Kharlamov is really built it by Van Imp. And he's prostrate on the ice. Van Imp from the penalty box ran into Kharlamov. The Soviets are all standing up. They want a penalty, but I'll tell you, Dick, that was a solid check, and I didn't see too much wrong with it.
They are leaving the ice.
They're going to go.
The Soviets are leaving.
They're going home. They're going home. Yeah, they're going home.
Hey, the owner of the Flyers, Eddie Snyder, went to the Soviets and said, hey, if you don't come back, you're not getting any dough. They came back and the Flyers beat them 4-1. Okay, now for some beauty hits, just like my buddy Eddie Van Imp. Confessions for some hardcore rock and roll. And I offer you redemption. A temporary satisfaction for your soul. Too much time, you can't take anymore. You got a one-track mission on your mind. In this hardcore rodeo, no, I don't have to ask the question, cause you're an animal and I'm ready to go. Too much talking, I can't take anymore.
I got a one-track mission on my mind.
Hey, here we now have Crosby drop the gloves with Zdlicky from Minnesota. Hey, Crosby can score gold medal goals, drop the gloves, pretty good too.
Willie Mitchell on Jonathan Taves.
All right, watch this one. Now, kids, keep your head up. Watch this suicide pass. This is a beauty coming across. Looked like he was changing or something there, eh? I love Taves. You know what I like to think about Jonathan. But here it is. Now, they have a little riot afterwards. Now, watch, they have a little riot afterwards. They go after him. I know you people say, why do they do that? It was a clean hit, and it was a clean hit. But you can't have your kid going like that. Get up, Jonathan. Don't you go down. Get up. You're a good Canadian boy. Get over there. More hits. I love it. Hey, let me tell you something, folks. I love those playoffs this year. That was rock'em sock'em hockey, I'll tell you. But how about Philly and New York Rangers? How about Philly makes it the last game on a shootout? And then they go down 3 with the Boston Bruins and they win. I'll tell you, boy, the playoffs are great. What a great playoffs this year. I loved it. Got to tell you, in that first round, players are hungry, and you got to keep your head up.
And every goal seems life and death.
Backhander scores! Recky goes in. Here's the spot back and then scores! And then backhand hit scores!
Everybody's got to pay the price or you're not going anywhere. Crosby, no look and a goal. Crosby with another beauty assist. Beauty overtime goals. Karkner sends it back to Pittsburgh.
Here comes the shot. Score! The shot from the blue line by Matt Karkner, and the Ottawa Senators have won this game.
Stahl with some great work, and Dupas wins the series for the Pens.
The shot is stopped.
Mechanic shocks the Caps in game one. Backroom saves the day for the Caps and ties the series at one game apiece. Satan scores in the second overtime on a power play for too many men on the ice. A sign of things to come for Boston.
Miro Satan, the overtime game!
Are the Bruins fans happy or what? My buddy Danny Cassello scores for Philly in game three. Now time for the best of the West. You know, last year was really anybody's cup to win. Any team that got a lucky bounce here or there could have won the whole thing.
Cloudy cuts to the net. Michael Samuelson moves in, takes the shot, scores!
Hey, lots of hits, great saves, and super goals.
Some open ice spins. What a save!
Look at this great save.
Miles, a one-timer and a quick. Out of the corner, keep the puck away. Daniel Sedin with a little back pass to his brother Henrik. Daniel heads for the net, takes the pass, scores! The puck in. He's got Frolov deep, gives him the puck. Modine scores!
Boyle, top corner.
Boyle now with urgency. He scores! Just this, Simmons after the puck. Spin, shoot, great save, Luongo!
Now the OT goals. Samuelsson puts the Canucks up 1-0. Hey, what I've always said, shots from the point.
Henrik in front, Samuelsson scores! Kopitar, quick pass back to Johnson, fakes it. Doughty, Kopitar, great block by Kessler. Kopitar scores!
Kopitar scores on his own rebound to tie the series at one game apiece.
Los Angeles Kings win tonight 3-2. A power play goal ties the series 1-1.
Hawks tie up the game versus the Preds with a shorthanded goal with 13 seconds left and an OT goal by Hossa gets the winner. Taniguchi scores a winner in game two and a wild 6-5 win. What do I always say? Stick on the ice, kids. It is a tough one, folks. Dan Boyle's shot goes off the stick of my buddy Ryan O'Reilly for the winner in a 1-0 game. I'll tell you, that was a killer. But the Sharks bounced back. Joe Pavelski scores a winner in the next game to tie the series at 2.
Pavelski with a snapshot, he scores!
Are they happy or what?
He ends it in overtime, and the series is tied.
All right, here it is. We're in the playoffs. We're going into overtime. It's game one in the playoffs. Let me tell you something, folks. The place is going nuts. So I got Jean Rattel out there. I got Ricky Middleton, and I got Donnie Marcotte. I look down at the bench, and he's putting in Bernie Parent. Wayne Stevenson has played the whole game. Going into overtime, he puts in Bernie Parent. I can't understand it. He's got to be cold. So I call the line over. He says, Jean, come here. Donnie, come here. Now look, I want you to get the puck over. Jean, get the puck over to Ricky. Get Ricky, you get it. I don't care what you do. Flip it on Bernie. Flip it on him. He's got to be cold.
Rick Smith to Middleton on the move. Trying to beat Jimmy Watson. He goes wide. He shoots. Scores! Goal! It's in! Rick Middleton has won the game as it's poked by Bernie Parent and just over the goal line. And Rick Middleton, his second rush down the right side, cut wide, drilled it. Parent had it, and then it just dropped over the line. Rick Middleton gives Boston the win.
And I did feel sorry for Bernie for just a second. Hey, now let's take a look at round two of the playoffs.
Waits, he gets it, a good chance. Center, four. Gianna shot, scores.
Still a lot of hitting, folks.
And on the other side, oh, it's Hansen. Got that big shot, and then great save by Halak. Big shot on the pilot in there. He sends it over. On the front of the goal, that is Hansen again.
How about Montreal? Havlak against the Pen, was he unbelievable or what? How about Philly coming back not only down 3-0 in games, but down 3-0 in game 7? Hey, what a way to get loose, Boston. I felt so sorry for them.
Like you saw in Coach's Corner, Camilleri, was he in a zone against the Pens or what? For some OT goals. Hey, my good buddy Mark Savard first came back from a concussion and he gets the winner in game one. Way to go, Savvy! Gagne gets the winner in game four to keep Philly alive. Little did he know, he started Philly on the road back to four straight wins. Unbelievable. Okay, here we go, round two from out west.
For Samuelson, he scores.
You knew Chicago and Vancouver, it was going to be a great series. Hey, the Sharks and Wings weren't too bad either.
Nemhoff takes the shot. Nemhoff the save. Rebounds. Shane O'Brien shoots.
I gotta tell you, Nemhoff has just stoned the Canucks.
Breaks it deep. Great save. Nemhoff. Here's Daniel. In front, a great save by Nemhoff. A 2-on-1 with Griffin to Cracker, he scores! Passes off, Tate scores!
Gets four goals and two assists in a 7-1 win in game five.
Couldn't shoot it. Patrick Sharp fed the puck across. Hold the middle.
Boy, was that great goaltending all around.
Keep the puck away right up the middle. Jose in front. Here comes Eager. Adam Burris trying to break away. He belongs. Stop by Luongo. To Sharp. He's in a long, deep straight. Save Luongo. Passes off. Taves trying to stuff it in. Scores! It jumps up. It's a 2-on-1. Wellwood, Bieksa scores! Here's Patrick Sharp to Brower. He scores! Across the ice, here's Pat Kane.
I am not sure what Kane calls this. Maybe the swim. Patrick Marleau gets the game winner when a beauty pass from Joe Thornton had put up the Sharks 3-0. Patrick will never get an easier overtime goal than that one. Okay, we won the first game in overtime, I tell you, it was a dandy, but now we're in the second game and we're in double overtime, if you can believe it. Terry O'Reilly, he jumps on by accident and he's standing right here and watch what happens.
Behind the net, Marcotte. In front, O'Reilly scores! Terry O'Reilly from Don Marcotte. The Bruins win in the second sudden death overtime with 9:53 left as Marcotte fed. Terry O'Reilly right in front, he jammed it home. A mob scene around Jerry Cheevers, who has been absolutely magnificent.
Now we're in the semifinals. It's the Flyers and the Habs. You gotta say, now really, nobody expected these two teams to be in the semifinals. Remember, Philly got in a shootout in the last game.
And then Colburn was open on this side, but they go to Briere. Shot. Goal! And on goal! Score!
3-0. They're in there again.
If you ask me, I think the difference in the series was that Philly really started to crash the net and bug Havlak. And Leighton, I gotta say, he had an easier time of it.
And it's in the goal. Fired it in front. It's fired in there behind everybody. It's out. And broken up and cleared. Down again to Giroux. The shot is stopped by Lockheed inside the blue line.
But in the end, folks, the Flyers were just too much for the Canadiens. But hey, Montreal, they had a great playoffs.
I'm a believer in this. I think they should pick it up.
They've earned it. They deserve it.
Okay, now it's the Sharks and the Hawks. I got to tell you, both teams come out hitting. Tell you, there was some nice goals in this series. And here's my buddy David Bolin. Oh, what a nice one. A beauty pass.
The shot short-handed. Mark Edward Plastic. Marlowe scores! Jumps up.
Niemanak keeps up his great play.
Off the bench, he shoots. Niemi the same. Patrick Marleau passes off, tipped right on. Straight up the middle, Pavelski passes off. Mitchell's shot. Now he's in trouble. Here's another short-handed break. Marleau shoots, stopped by Niemi. Again, Taves lost the handle. And Bob Butler scores!
Butler scores the OT winner, and Hawks take a 3-0 lead in the series. What a pass by my buddy Bolin. The Hawks go on to sweep the series. You know, in sports, there's nothing like the Stanley Cup Finals. And to me, anyhow, it's like a heavyweight championship fight. I love it. And this year was no different. Let me tell you, Fire Chicago, they took no prisoners. Are you ready? Let's go! Game one in Chicago. Hey, you know, these two guys were going to go at it, and they did.
Rogers on the ice again. He's played four the first 6.5 minutes as the Flyers get the puck to the net, and it's in. A bouncing puck gets behind Avi Niemi. Tripling in the Flyers zone. Barrett lost his stick. Hossa sees it. There's a shot by Bauer. He scores! Here comes Dustin Butler.
Niemann has stopped 17 shots in the first period, and they let him go.
That was blocked. Breer again scores! The Blackhawks have been dominant there. Here's a 2-on-1. It's Sharp. He shoots, he scores!
Yeah, it was seesaw back and forth.
Different-looking line. Brower, Sharp, and Kane. Aaron Asham. Here's Claire Betts with a shot. He scores! This is the puck. Into the attacking zone, here comes Thomas Kopetsky. Centering pass, proceeds, scores! Hossa, centering pass, comes back to Jolmes, and all he does is hold the puck in. Here's Hossa with Sargent, trying to centering pass, Jolmes scores!
I gotta tell you, it wasn't Leighton's night, but he'd be back.
Here comes Chris Verskeek, centering pass. Boucher makes a great save. Here's Pierre with a shot. He's got Colbert carrying, he shoots. That's Hartnell with it. Hartnell takes the pass, hits the trailer. Asham can't shoot. Pierre to Asham, one-timer scores! He the skates and he fell down. The Bolin kept the puck in. Verskeek out front, Kopetsky scores!
Jayhawks with a crazy one, 6-5.
And now game two in Chicago.
Checked by Richards, who stole the puck, takes the shot, the empty to save. Keith has joined the rush, and he shoots, Clayton with the save. Here's Brent Siebel, Duncan Keith into Sharp, he shoots, Clayton to save, rebound,
I love seeing those tough guys score.
Campbell, Kopetsky alongside. Jeff Carter knocked down, and look at this, nose to nose. Thomas Kopetsky and Dan Carcillo. Slap pass, side of the net. Gagne stopped by the end. Here's a steal. Bauer stop. Rebound. Hossa Greg shoots, and that's blocked in front of the net. Bowen, there's a shot that lands by Trump. Corner comes the captain, and he shoots, and Leighton fights that off. Kennelly's just about over. There's the shot by Gagne, scores!
Hey, Leighton keeps Philly in there, and they score to make it 2-1.
Here's a chance for Ashton, and what a save by Niemi. Carcillo again, snaps the shot. Timo teaming it to the net. The save is made, and the puck is loose. Mike Richards behind the defense. He's stopped by
Miami. Niemi makes 32 saves, and the Hawks go up 2-0. Hey, game three was in Philly, and you know the joint was going to be rocking.
Thomas Kopetsky. Bounces one in on Michael. Hold of the puck as a Patrick Sharp. He's got Hossa with him. He gave him the puck. His shot, a nice save by Leighton. Take it by Giroux. Colbert shot. Oh, what a save by Niemi. They score. Denny Briere. Straight up the middle. Darryl Powell turns and fires. Giroux plays it back. Chris Carter. Wrist shot deflected. Oh, didn't go in. It's stopped on the line. Off, the light is on, but I don't think that puck got across the goal.
Hey, was it a goal?
It was a goal. Won the draw. Sofo shoots, he scores! Another shot knocked down in front of the goal. Tage gets it, feeds it ahead. Here's Patrick Kane, scores! The board, the puck is stolen. There's a hot shot, and Niemi made the save on the neutral zone. There's a steal by guess who? Billy Leno. Thomas doesn't have a stick. Briere, stop! Sorry, pass, rebound, score!
We go to overtime.
There's a chance in the front of the net.
Say, was it a goal?
Here's Briere, Matt Carl, tips it on, his goal!
It was, and Philly wins, and Leighton makes 33 saves. Way to go, Leighton. Hey, the Philly fans are ready.
Don't make no plans for next Wednesday night, because we'll be right back here in Philadelphia to lift the Stanley Cup.
Continues as Jeff Carter, he shoots and Niemi makes the save. Billy Leno, Briere, hit the puck. Mike Richards and Billy Leno. And Ogagne is powered by a steal and a goal. Mike Richards.
Hey, this one was all Philly early.
Held it in along the boards. Here's Claude Giroux. Coming off the bench is James Van Riemsdyk with a spinorama in front of the net. Giroux turns and fires. They score!
shots. Hartnell didn't get the puck out. Sharp with a shot, scores! Deflected as Patrick Sharp.
In the last minute of the first period, Hartnell holds up. Waiting for Tiedemann off the bench. Side of the net, he scores! Patrick Kane. Tate goes to the front of the net this time. Duncan Keith takes the shot, tipped in by Boland.
The Hawks are keeping it close, though.
To the front of the net, a bouncing puck, they score! Looked like it went off Jonathan Tate. Mesquite battling in front. There's a tip, Seabrook right on. Martin Scopa, one-timer, Austin Sticks. Tate can't beat Layton. Tate again, wrap around. Duncan Keith shoots, just missed it in. Here's Brent Seabrook back in front of the box and hit the puck. And he goes wide of the net. Duncan Keith can't hold the puck in. Jeff Carter steals it. Open net. Game over.
And now back to Chicago. Dustin Byfuglien was a one-man wrecking crew. Two goals, two assists, and lots of bodies flying, and they let him go. Are they nuts?
He shoots, he scores! Get to the point. Here's Brent Sobel. Turns, puts the puck to the net. Boland scores! Brian Campbell. Up the middle comes Blair Betts. There's the shot. Rebound. Betts couldn't find it. Pass off, then he got over his stick. Here comes Ladd. Sharp shoots. Big rebound. Sharp again. Stop fighting. Two on two. Trying to make it three on two is Buffalo. For Steve, it's off. He shoots. He scores. Back to the blue line. Cover just off the bench to Tiedemann, and he shoots. Rebound. The Emmy stopped that too. Patrick Sharp. Ahead to Andrew Ladd. He's got Kane, but he shoots. Another shot. Comes up with a puck and drive. Richards, oh, what a save by the Andy 11. The Taves in on Carter. He shoots. Kane, quick pass to Keith. Side of the net, Taves to Buffuglien. Scores! And the game with Andrew Ladd. Sharp to Taylor. Shoot. Scores! Gives Leno a chance to move out. He's got Simone Gagné ridden, and Keith doesn't have a stick. Billy Leno to the net. Passes off. Gagné scores! What a goal created by
Kane reminds me of another Blackhawk, Dennis Savard, with these moves.
Here's Buffalo, shoots for the open net.
And now game six. Better keep your head up in Philly.
Slides into the middle, passes off. Patrick Kane, Jonathan Taves, Byfuglien scores! Now back to Konger. Here's Danny Briere, walks in, shoots, the empty to save, Konger scores! Kane takes over. Byfuglien's with him, they crisscross. Kane shoots, leaking the screen. Cross for Sokol, there's a screen, slap pass, side of the net.
Both goalies are keeping their teams in there.
The stanchion, Keith wires it. Leno, and a pitching cover, and there's a chance for Richards. And he flips the puck in the air to center. Leno knocked it down, onside, Billy Leno. The way into the attacking zone, passes into the middle, Boland passes off, Sharp scores! Matt Carl pinches down, held the puck in, thrown to the net, loose puck, Giroux, stopped by the Emmy! Here's Brayden Coburn, who's joined the rush, Jeff Carter shoots, the Emmy stopped it! There's a rebound there, though he couldn't stop the play. Here's a steal, Simone Gagné, in a low, stopped by the Emmy! Giveaway, Richards! Just about got away with that. Now he throws the puck to the front of the net. Bouncing puck, Giroux! Matt Carl under pressure in his own zone. He lost the puck. Patrick Kane won't give it up. Nicklas Hjalmarsson shoots, deflected, they score! And
out of the cage to Marian Hossa. Bends with it. So here comes Taves. Stopped by Leighton. Back to the front of the net. It's like Jamison got a high stick. Giroux. Side of the net. Carter. White saved the Emmy. Keith follows him. No one has the puck. Little backhand pass to Duncan. Keith fires a shot off the post. Out here with Briere and Hartnell. Gets through the neutral zone, into the attacking zone. Hartnell heads for the net. Briere's already there. Does he put this goal?
Scotty Hartnell ties up the game and he sends it into overtime.
Sheldon along the board. Andrew Ladd, checked by Coburn. Campbell holds the puck into the line. Turns, won't shoot. Kane, watched by Timo Tiivanen. To the net! And he stopped it. Where's the puck?
And Kane knew it was in.
Patrick Kane has scored the goal. The Chicago Blackhawks' long zone is over.
He still can't find the puck.
And there it is.
There's the puck.
Well, congratulations to the Hawks. I gotta tell you, folks, that's moments to live forever.